Without power this morning after a storm tore down trees and branches. It happened in southwest Louisville, mostly in the PRP area. Gary Parker joins us live now, where neighbors will likely be spending the afternoon cleaning up storm damage. Gary.
Eric, good afternoon. I mean, this storm was small, but it packed a punch. Just look right behind me. This is what we found, and this is the worst damage that we've seen. You can see a tree, a very large tree, rather, that just sort of snapped off and fell on top of this home. And as you were just saying, neighbors spending the day after 4th of July cleaning up this mess.
Well, when you look outside, you don't see nothing. You know, it's just, it looked like this water was just white. It was like a fog.
An eerie awakening for Don Letcher.
It didn't sound like no winds or nothing like that. It sounded like a train. As soon as it hit, it sounded like a train.
An early morning storm trashes southwest Louisville, tearing down limbs, knocking down trees, some of them even landing on houses, smashing rooftops and windows, like this home on Sky Blue Avenue and Vassar.
It was pretty strong winds that we could hear, and it scared me.
LG&E reports the storm left over 2,000 without power. Utility crews worked quickly to bring residents out of the dark.
I looked out my front door here, and it looked like that tree limbs were coming down.
There was a loud boom and a blue flash. So I think that's what took the trees out and caused the outage.
Now, the day after Independence Day, neighbors are cleaning up the mess.
I've got a big tree on the boat and everything, and her branches down here, but across the street, they got a lot more damage as far as tree damage.
But overall, neighbors say this was the strangest storm they've ever seen.
You couldn't even put your hand out in front of you and see how it was. That's how bad it was when you looked out the door.
And we've seen utility crews working all morning around this area, just trying to get those power lines back functioning for the thousands of people that were affected in this. LG&E now reporting 115 people still without power, something very important to get done, especially on a sweltering day like this. But the good news is most of the power is up. Reporting live, I'm Gary Parker, WLKY News.